Hello, this is another worked example for year 9 physics revision. This particular worked example is on moment, the principle of moment. As you can see, this diagram shows a simple tool for punching holes in a leather belt. we use this every day, but little do we know that this has something to do with physics. So if you look at this, if this is our pivot, you know, and this, there is a hole punch here, there's a steel peg here, which will be acting, there's a force acting upwards there, and the force applied is acting downwards there. Now, by the principle of movement, you know that anti-clockwise moment should be equal to clockwise moment. So if you look at this setup, it's a balanced setup in the sense that if you apply force here, there is another force that is opposing it, and that keeps it balanced. But if that force is hard enough, it will then press the steel peg inside the leather belt. Now, let's look at the question that comes from that. When the handle is pressed down, the steel peg presses down on the piece of leather. If the force is large enough, the peg punches through the leather, making a hole. Okay, and this diagram shows that. And as I have already drawn off here, I can actually show that the diagram is still valid. The arrow diagram that I drew before was still valid. If this is our pivot, we use this to this triangle to represent the pivot, and precisely that will represent a force that is going up, and these 50 newtons represent a force that is going down. If that is F1, that is F2. And between F2 and this distance, and the pivot is 4 centimeters, and between F1 and the pivot is 10 centimeters. So our moment, principle of moment, is actually sorted. So give the moment of the 50 newtons force. The moment of the 50 newtons force will be F1 times 10 centimeter, and F1 in this case is 50 newtons, is gonna be 50 newtons times 10 centimeter, and that will be 500 newton centimeter. Now, that will carry 2 marks because it's the definition of moment itself will be 1 mark, and the right answer, the correct answer with the correct unit, will be the second mark. Now, it then goes on to ask us, the moment makes the peg press down on the leather. So, we've already done this, let's rub it off. So the question now is, calculate the force with which the steel peg presses down on the leather. And this is where we go back to the original diagram. If we go back to the original diagram, we now need to establish the principle of moment. So we can just, I would just say this is the F peg, which is FP. So if we use the principle that anti-clockwise moment, okay, equals clockwise moment. So our anti-clockwise moment will be the moment that goes, if you allow this to go up that way, it will be that one, Fp multiplied by 4 centimeter. And the clockwise moment will be the moment that is coming this way, and that will be 50 newtons multiplied by 10 centimeter. Now, if you rearrange, Fp will then become 50 newtons multiplied by 10 centimeter divided by 4 centimeter. That cancels out, so you end up with, you know, 5 times 100 over 4. And that is 5 times 25, which is 125 newtons. So the amount of force that is needed here to balance the effect of 50 newtons on this system will be 125 newtons, which is quite a lot, you know, more than twice the size of the force that is used originally. And that is how you do that. And that calculation will go with that. The moment makes the steel peg press down the leather, calculate the force with which the steel peg presses down the leather, and that will be the calculation for that. So if we now go on to the next question, which says, the next time the punch is used, the steel peg presses down on the leather with a force of 150 newtons. Okay, so that means we are changing Fp to 150. Right, the area of the end of the steel peg is 0.1 centimeters squared, so the area is 0.1 centimeters squared. Let's clean off what we don't need. Okay, what is the pressure of the steel peg on the leather? Now that takes us back to the formula of the pressure. The pressure is force divided by area. And since we know the force and we know the area, we can just say it's 150 divided by 0.1 centimeters squared. Now, we need to get the unit right. So if we use this, that's gonna be 1500 newton per centimeter squared. But if we decide to change that to meter, it will be something like that. I would advise that you leave it this way. Otherwise, you get yourself into trouble. And that gives you 2 marks there. Now, the pressure is too small and the punch does not go through the leather. How could you change the design of the punch to make it work using the same force on the handle? Now, what we can do is if we want to change the pressure and want to keep the pressure, the force the same, then what we can do, for instance, give an example, if the force pressure is 150 newtons over 0.1, and that gave us 1500 newtons per centimeter squared, and we're saying that it's too small. So what we can then do if we want to increase the pressure without changing the force is to reduce the area. So we can then reduce the area, basically by reducing the area, for instance, to say 0.05 or 0.01, we can then have 0.01 centimeters squared. That will give us 15,000 newtons per centimeter squared, which is a higher pressure. So increasing the area increased would be one way of doing that, because only one mark, that is decreasing the area. Okay, area decreased would be one way of doing that. The other way of doing that is actually to increase the length of the pivot, so that the effort that is being used to press it will need a longer distance, and that will equate the amount of force that is needed there. But that is basically what you need to do for this kind of question.